third sitting.
Well, we're here at the third sitting of the luncheon here in the dining car on this exclusive and elegant Tracks on Tracks trip. Now, you may look at us and say, look at these guys, a little rough around the edges, look a little haggard, look at these. But really, we're really rolling this pretty sophisticated, you know? We're listening to the announcements. I think we're really doing a great job as passengers so far, although I suspect some of the staff would probably...
Beg to differ.
I think we're probably a C-minus in some of the staff.
We may be being painted with the same brush as many, many people. Yeah.
Well, anyway, a few things that we've learned about the train so far, and this is...
The beauty. I think you want to try and capture a little bit of that, tilt it up. Sorry about that.
All right, so we're... It's about 1 in the afternoon or something like that on our second day, but it's already confusing, less than 24 hours in, because we were up to like all hours. I think we rolled till we kept on rocking till about 6 in the morning, was it?
Yeah, I think we were the sun was coming up, it was very beautiful. We were trying to hold on for the sunrise, but it was cloudy, so we kind of gave up on that.
Speaking of beautiful, say hello. Say hello to the internets.
How's it going?
Good. So this lovely lady, Adaline, was singing for us in one of the cars that I've lost track of. There's like park cars and there's skyline cars and
the upstairs car.
Yes, that one.
What's it called?
I have no idea.
The sky car.
I've lost track of them all. It was pretty nice though, singing, you know, because I heard the electronic music and then with the guitar, that was just lovely.
Yes, and today I'm going to do a more acoustic set. Today I'm going to do an acoustic set and then tonight I'm going to do a electro set.
Well, I'm going to listen to it all. And you folks out there, continue your jealous rage. So to go on with this, I think that us as passengers here on Tracks and Tracks, we've gotten to know each other quite well, and we're doing a great job at that. I would give us an A on that. However, us getting to know the train rules, it's a little baffling, right? Like, it shouldn't be this fucking confusing to do anything on a train. There's a lot of rules, a lot of shakedowns. You got to be wearing shoes. And if you don't wear shoes, you are going to hear about it, hey? You get a lecture?
Same rules at home. You can drink at your house, you can't drink in the street, or bring your own booze to drive.
But it seems ridiculous because we're on a confined thing, right? Like, there's not too much we can do. So we're sort of trying to play friendly. I, of course, brought my own beer stein, which helps a little bit. I don't know why everyone doesn't bring a beer stein and soaked pajamas on a train trip. It seems sensible. And that wasn't on your packing list.
I feel stupid for not bringing those things.
Well,
sure.
I brought an extra stein for you.
That was good. That's pretty good.
Not quite as high end.
Oh, speak of the announcements.
Oh, yeah.
We have now arrived at another seated point of interest.
Oh, seated point of interest.
So that is on the right-hand side of the train.
Oh, look at this. It's though you're on the train with us.
Lake, which is one of the largest lakes in the Canadian Rockies, Follow the shoreline.
Largest lake in the Canadian Rockies. We're going to follow the shoreline for about 8 miles or kilometers.
And it has an average depth of 300 feet, but it is considered to be a bottomless lake. And with most significance, this is the headwaters of the Fraser River.
Oh, look at that. Headwaters of the Fraser River is bottomless and also 300 feet deep. Dude, it seems like an oxymoron. But again, as we're finding out on the train, everything's a little bit different. My favorite thing so far about the train, though, might be the shower. The showers are awesome.
Except
and endless hot.
The train stops.
I gotta say, the beds, the ones we were in anyway, they like seem pretty basic. But when you get in there, it is cozy. Good for napping. Good for like quiet times. Good for the end of the night or the beginning of the morning, whatever happens.
Whichever one it was. And so last night in the Skyline car, besides Adaline, guys, Portage and Maine were laying it down. I love that.
Chris Ho,
the
original.
Ian Bevis, Bear Mountain.
Ian Bevis threw down some acoustic folk music. We know him for his stint in Topless Caleb Techno Party and Bear Mountain, very electronic focused music. But he has this, I don't know who to compare it to. He's kind of got that voice, that raspiness.
Yeah,
I'm thinking of all the originals. They all come to mind. So I don't really want to list off them all. But
yes.
You know Bob Dylan, Neil Young, Neil Simon.
You know, the huge. No big deal, right? No pressure there yet. And so as we as the train rolls on, we'll be enjoying many more various performances in various cars.
If we can figure out the time zones and the timing of the shows, because there's that whole thing going on too.
Yeah.
No, is it starting right now? 2:30.
See, that's what we need an announcement
for. I'm right on top of it.
There's going to be some music.
It's
you should
Adaline,
get your ass up.
2:30 in the party car. Yeah, and then at 3 o'clock, it's Chris Ho at the very end, the last car, the park car. And then I think there's another thing in the Skyline car, but that's 8 o'clock.
Wow. There's something going on when we get to Jasper as well.
I think there's like some kind of station show. Yeah, it's
anyway,
like all kinds of music.
Anyway, okay. Nice dinner. Six all right. Second, eight.
All right, Daniel's back, and he's got some questions for us, so I'm going to let you go. See everyone out there from Tracks on Tracks. Just keep on rolling, man.
So, Adaline, how are you doing on the train so far? We're halfway through. We're rolling through the prairies. How do you feel?
I'm feeling like I've gone pretty hard the last 2 days. It's been fun. I don't think I really knew what to expect from the trip, but I figured it would be kind of similar to previous group musician experiences where it would just be a lot of fun, and it's been exactly that. Canadian musicians are pretty fun people, so it's been good.
Can you compare this trip to anything you've ever done before?
Yes, I can compare this trip. I think, you know, I was in the Peak Performance Project for 2 years, and it has that sort of family feeling. What's nice about this, and, you know, the Peak is it's a competition, and so sometimes you're in that mode, so this is nice because there's just absolutely no reason to compete. It's just having fun and collaborating and, you know, getting to know other people. And a lot of these musicians I don't know, so it's been really fun.
And who have you collaborated with so far?
The first night I did a lot of singing with Portage of Maine. They were breaking out the hits. I did a little bit with that. And then I've been singing with, I really want to collaborate with the Sydney York girls. That's a goal of mine. They're somewhere here. And we are still to have our dance beat party. I'm gonna do we're gonna have a synth off with the topless people.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm gonna take them on. I know there's 7 of them and 1 of me, but I feel that's the challenge maybe tonight.
You said you've been collaborating with, or singing with Portage and Maine. What were you singing?
Well, they're singing some original stuff, and I was just sort of, they're doing a Southern Souls video in Toronto in a few days, so I'm gonna go and sing with that and with them. And, it's been pretty busy so far, so I feel like today and tomorrow it will be mostly when a lot of the collaborations happen, because I think we're just, the first day or two, you're just kind of getting to know people and getting a feel for everyone, but it's starting to feel like, we have recording software here, we have, so I'm sure we'll start doing some of that stuff.
Can you tell me, you did a special performance yesterday, can you tell me about that?
Is it bad if I don't remember the special performance?
Listen carefully to the sound of a loneliness, like a heartbeat driverless, in the stillness of remembering what you have, what you lost, and what you
busy little bees with no connection.